ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन. शिवा एंड आई थैंक यू फॉर ग्रेसिंग अस विद योर प्रेजेंस ऑन दिस ब्यूटीफुल एंड ऑस्पिशियस ओकेशन टुडे इन फ्रंट ऑफ अ ग्रुप एंड ऑल दोस हु मार्वल एट द आर्ट ऑफ डांस एंड ऑल ऑफ यू. संजीता वुड हम्बली डेमोन्स्ट्रेट ऑल दैट शी हैज लर्न सो फार इन हर डांस जर्नी. वी वुड ऑल्सो लाइक टू अप्रिशिएट यू ऑल हर taking the time off on a Sunday evening to come and give you a blessings, love and support on this occasion. With that, we would like to introduce the MC for this evening, Smita Prasanna, who's not new to many of us. Smita is a very good friend of us. It was Smita who first identified Sanjita's passion for dance. Without further delay, I'll leave the floor to our cheerful, energetic and enthusiastic MC Smita, who will walk us through the rest of the evening. I hope you all enjoy the program. Thank you.
Thanks Maha and Shiva for the warm introduction. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Good evening everyone and welcome once again to Sanjita's Arangetram. Today's Arangetram is a much awaited event for many of us in Houston, and I am sure you're all as excited as I am to see Sanjita light up the stage this evening. But first, let us look at some housekeeping rules. Please silence your cell phones. While photography without flash is allowed, please refrain from video recording or live broadcast of the performance. We request parents with young children to be seated at the end of the row or exit so you will have easy access in case you need to leave immediately. Unless an emergency, kindly exit in between dance items and not while the dancer is performing on stage. I would now like to start by giving a brief introduction of the star of today's evening. Sanjita Chinta is a seventh grader at Fourth Settlement Middle School. She is 12 years old and has been learning Bharatanatyam under the tutelage of Guru Srimati Lavanya Prabhu since the age of 5. She is the youngest Tattvam student thus far to have advanced to the level of performing an Arangetram. This is a testament to the dedication of the Guru, the disciple, as well as the encouragement and motivation of parents to make this possible at such a young age. Sanjita is also blessed to be born in a family of dance lineage. She hails from a family of traditional dancers of the Kuchipudi village who preserve the Kuchipudi dance in all its pristine purity. Sanjita's great-grandfathers are the recipients of Sangeet Natak Academy Award, Padma Shri Awards, and many prestigious awards in India. Other than dancing, she loves to play violin and has been learning both the Western and Carnatic styles. She learns violin from Sri R.K. Kailasham, senior disciple of violin maestro Professor T.N. Krishnan. Sanjita has won many competitions representing the Tattvam School of Dance and was placed second in the nationwide Bharatanatyam solo competition held by the Saptami Foundation. Without further ado, we will commence today's Arangetram with a soulful invocation by Sanjita's friend Dhriti Balaji.
Shri Ganapati ni sevim paraje shrita manavu lara sevim paraje shrita manavu lara vaga dipati su pujail je kuni vaga जे कुनी Panasanari keda di jambu pala mulanare ginji Panasanari keda di jambu pala mulanare ginji ganatarambu nanu mahi pai pada mulagallu gallane nunchi anaya muhari charana yugamulanu hridaya bujamuna nunchi vinayamunanu tyagaraja vinutudu vividagatule dittalangumani vedalinashi kanna paithini sevimparare shritama nambulara
That was amazing. Thank you, Dhriti, for the beautiful invocatory piece on Lord Ganesha. I'd like to start this evening's recital by sharing an interesting piece of information on the origin of Bharatanatyam. The Vedas are considered to be one of the most sacred scriptures of the Hindu religion. Legend has it that the gods and goddesses asked Lord Brahma, the creator of the universe, to create a fifth Veda which would be accessible to the common man. Lord Brahma then created the Natya Veda, which is an essence of all the four Vedas. He took the words from the Rig Veda, the gestures from the Yajur Veda, the music and chant from Sama Veda, and sentiments and emotions from the Atharva Veda to form the Natya Veda. Lord Brahma then shared it with sage Bharata to popularize and preach on earth. Following the instructions of the Lord, sage Bharata wrote the Natya Shastra, a great comprehensive work on the science and technique of Indian drama, dance, and music. This is considered to be the oldest treatise on the theory of the Indian performing arts. After the compilation of the Natya Shastra, sage Bharata presented a scene from the Kurma avatar with his apsaras, the celestial damsels, to Lord Shiva and Goddess Parvati. The beautiful Ramba, Urvashi, Tilotama, and Menaka enacted the scene of the churning of the ocean of milk. Lord Shiva, on seeing the performance, suggests that it should include more nritta and demonstrates by performing the powerful Tandava. When sage Bharata says that his dainty apsaras will not be able to perform such vigorous movements, Goddess Parvati steps in and demonstrates how to perform the same movements with grace, or lasya, and thus Bharatanatyam blossomed. The technique of this art form has evolved over the centuries to become one of the most comprehensive dance forms in the world, combining nritya, or pure dance, nritya, or interpretive dance, and abhinaya of the highest order. Now, with an understanding of the origin of Bharatanatyam, let us step into this evening's arangetram. The program begins with a Todaya Mangalam in praise of Veeratishwarar, the Gaja Samhara Murti, the presiding deity of the Varuvur temple. This will be followed by a Pushpanjali, a floral tribute, where the dancer offers flowers to the deity and invokes his blessings. Sanjita offers her salutations to Lord Ganesha, the remover of all obstacles. This Pushpanjali is in Ragam Arabi, set to Adi Talam, a composition of Dr. Balamurli Krishna.
Jai Mahasaya, Jai Mahasaya, Jai Mahasaya, Jai Mahasaya,
jem jem tanana tak jem jem tanana kundari gitat kundari
Thank you.
that was a divine opening item. And if that's a start, I'm eager to see what more is in store for us. The next item is a Kautuvam. Kautuvam is a hymn or a song of devotion in praise of a deity. In olden times, Kautuvams were typically performed as part of the daily rituals and special occasions during temple processions. In a Kautuvam, the sollukattas or the rhythmic syllables are intertwined with the lyrics of the song. This is first recited and then sung to a tune which adds an interesting dimension to the performance. There are many types or variations in Kautuvams. We have Kautuvams that are specific to a temple, like the Natesha Kautuvam or Nataraja of Chidambaram. We have Kautuvams in praise of deities, but not specific to any temple. We have the Navasandhi Kautuvams on the gods ruling the 9 junctions or directions, and many more. Sanjita today will be dancing an Andal Kautuvam. Adi and Margadi, 2 months of the Hindu calendar, are known to be significant for those who are on a spiritual journey. They are often associated, among many others, to Andal, who is considered an incarnation of Bhumi Devi. This Kautuvam describes the story of Andal, who was the great poetess and saint of the 9th century, the only woman to be recognized as an Arvar. She was found among the Tulsi shrubs by her father, Vishnu Chittar, in the city of Srivilliputtur on an auspicious Friday in the month of Adi. Her father was a very pious devotee of Lord Vishnu and gathered fresh flowers from his garden every day to make huge garlands that adorned the Lord. Andal grew up into a beautiful young girl and fell in love with Lord Ranganatha and began to first wear the garland herself before giving it to her father to take to the temple. She did this to symbolize the divine love that existed between her and Lord Vishnu until she finally merged with him in the temple. Let us celebrate her with this beautiful Nachiyar Kautuvam in Ragam Atana, set to Sarvalagu Thalam, a composition by Sri Gangai Muthu Nattuvanar.
Thank you.
Now that was a beautiful portrayal of Andaal, wasn't it? The next item is a shabdam. In a margam, the shabdam is the first item in which expressions or abhinaya are included. The jatis or the rhythmic sequences are recited, and the line usually ends with the phrase tai tatata. Today, Sanjita will be performing the very special Manduka Shabdam. This is also called Gajendra Moksha Shabdam and is very popular in the Kuchipudi repertoire. It was later adapted by Sri Balbo Ramaya Pillai himself into the Bharatanatyam style of dance. This Shabdam is in praise of Lord Vishnu. The poet starts by first describing a scene of a lush, thick forest filled with fragrant flowers and creepers. There is a beautiful pond that is filled with fragrant lilies and lotuses and thousands of croaking frogs or mandukas. It is in this pond that the Gajendra Moksham occurs. The poet praises the virtues of Lord Vishnu, who saved the elephant king Gajendra from the clutches of the evil crocodile and released him from the curse of sage Durvasa. It is called Manduka Shabdam as the poet captures the croaking of the frog in the lake where the elephant fought the crocodile. The unique feature of this Shabdam is the intermediate jatis, which were composed much like the croaking frogs. You will also notice that the salutations to Lord Vishnu are given by using the word salam, which is due to the Islamic influence that existed at that time period. Also, another interesting tidbit is that Sanjita's father performed the very same Manduka Shabdam in his Kuchipudi Ranga Pravesham. Manduka Shabdam in Raga Malika, said to Mishra Chaputalam, a composition by Sri Melattur Kasinadaya.
Thank you. Hey,
Captivating performance, and Sanjita delivered with such precision. We now have a few guests who would like to say some words on Sanjita's special day. First, I would like to introduce Sanjita's uncle, Mr. Prakash. He is a senior management professional who was inspired by Swami Chinmayananda and started the Chinmaya Mission in Kansas City along with his wife Rajashree. They are both actively involved in teaching India's rich spiritual heritage and the fundamentals of Vedanta to become positive contributors in the society. I now invite Mr. Prakash to please come on stage and share your few words.
Hari Om and Namaste to all. I don't know how I'm going to talk, especially after watching what Sanjita has performed, totally mesmerizing. It's my privilege and honor to stand in front of you to speak a few words about my niece Sanjita. Today is a day to celebrate the achievements of a goal that was only possible due to more than 7 years of hard work and discipline. Though Sanjita is at the center of today's event, she would not have reached this milestone without the support of her parents and her guru, Srimati Lavanya Prabhu. Sanjita is fortunate to learn Bharatanatyam from Srimati Lavanya, one of the torchbearers of the Varavur dance tradition. She belongs to a great Guru Shishya Parampara. One can say that Nataraja Samarambam, Sri Valluvur Ramaya Pillai Madhyamam, Sanjita's Acharya Paryantam, Vande Guru Paramparam. A loose translation of this is salutations to the lineage of Gurus, starting with Lord Nataraja, the Adi Guru, sustained by Gurus like Sri Valluvur Ramaya Pillai in the middle, and continuing up to Sanjita's immediate teacher, Srimati Lavanya. Sanjita's guru has not only taught her a lifelong art, but also imparted valuable life skills. Thank you. Of course, I must mention about my sister, Mahalakshmi, and my brother-in-law, Shiva. It is the sacrifice, love, and dedication at every step of the way that has made this possible. The past 1 year has been one of the most memorable years for them. The time and effort put in by Mahalakshmi and Shiva is immense, and they're going to cherish this for their lifetime. Sanjita was born in a family where both music and dance have been an integral part. It is no wonder that she has taken to both these art forms. She imbibes several qualities from her parents, like kindness, determination, and focus, etc. Those who know Sanjita would agree that she has always displayed these qualities in whatever task she has set her eyes on. These traits were in full display even at a very young age. When she was 4 years old, Sanjita was visiting us in Kansas during one of the winter breaks. We took Sanjita and our sons Arjun and Gautam to a skiing place. Though Sanjita had not skied before, she had learned the techniques very quickly and was able to ski well, pretty much matching both my boys' skills. That's an amazing feat indeed. Although Sanjita is engaged in various other activities, we could see that it is dance where passion lies. Anytime she talks about dance, we could see the glow in her eyes, the sparkle in her eyes. After Arangetram, Sanjita wants to continue Bharatanatyam, of course. She also wants to learn Natuvangam from her guru. I wish her all the best and pray to God that all her dreams and wishes come true. As I conclude my speech, I cannot help but think of my parents who would have really enjoyed this Arangetram had they been here. But I'm sure wherever they are, obviously in heaven, they will be blessing her from there. I once again thank you all for coming to Sanjita's dance Arangetram, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the program. Thank you and namaste.
Thank you, Mr. Prakash. The love of family and friends is what glues our hearts together. We have two of Sanjita's friends who are waiting to talk about her. I now invite Keya and Akriti to come on stage, please. Akriti would first like to say a few words.
Hi everyone, I hope you're enjoying the show. I'm Akriti, or Aku as many of you know me as, one of Sanjita's best friends. Honestly speaking, she's one of the most annoyingest little people I've ever met. The only thing she's good for? Laughing at my terrible jokes. But she laughs at everything, so it doesn't do much to my self-esteem. Anyone need a person to laugh at your jokes? She's the one to call. I'm telling you, no one has more snacks than Sanjita. Every time I go there, I'm snacking on something when I leave. Same with the Harry Potter movies. I've watched all of them. The reason I've watched all of them, Shivankul plays them for the kids at the parties because we have nothing else to do. All jokes aside, Sanjita is one of the most hardworking and talented people I know. This one time, my mom told me that Sanjita wakes up at 5 a.m. on school days, does all her extracurricular activities before she leaves for school. I can barely catch the bus. Everything that Sanjita has ever achieved, she's worked so hard for, including this day. On the way to Arangetram's, she used to tell me that she just practiced for 3 hours, and this just casually gets out of the car, like her feet aren't in so much pain. At 5 years old, she had the same violin teacher as my 15-year-old brother. Everything you did, Sanjita was always one step ahead. I don't think Lavanyanti ever corrected her for her elbows, because of the way she practices over and over and over to become the best dancer she could ever be. I always thought I would be Sanjita's role model, not the other way around.
Hello everyone. My name is Kea and I'm Sanjita's best friend. Sanjita and I first met each other at the Houston Swim Club when we were 3 years old. Me and Sanjita started learning from Lavanyanti back in 2015, and ever since then we've been dancing together. It's been a wonderful experience being able to have someone like Sanjita dancing with you. She is amongst one of the sweetest people I've ever met. She always has a big, infectious smile on her face and will try to make the best out of everything. From swimming to ice skating, Girl Scouts, volleyball, we've done a lot together. We've had some amazing times at a Hindu camp we die to go to every year. It's the highlight of our summer vacation. Bunking with Sanjita was a task. Most of the nights, I would be sleeping without a blanket, or she was pulling on my blanket from below. She goes above and beyond for pretty much everything. Recently in Girl Scouts, there were a few topics we could choose to talk about during our camping trip. Sanjita here, the only one from the entire troop, she wrote an entire essay on invasive species. She's truly an overachiever. Still, who does that? I'm really proud of Sanjita today. To achieve something this big at such a young age, I don't know how she does it. She's been working so hard since the last 2 years, all up to this day, and her performance truly shows her hard work and dedication. She talks a lot and sometimes can be annoying, doesn't always rent me and ride her hoverboard, but that doesn't come in the way of her being one of the greatest friends one could have. Sanjita, if you're listening, thank you so much for being a wonderful friend, and I can't really express in words how much you mean to me. I'm very blessed to have you in my life, whom I know I can always count on. You're more like a sister to me than a best friend. I'm looking forward to create many more wonderful memories and a lifetime of friendship. I love you.
Thank you, girls, for sharing some information about Sanjita that we did not know. Ladies and gentlemen, we now have a small video presentation for you to enjoy. Yeah! It is difficult to imagine a life without color, isn't it? It brings beauty, variety, and makes life more interesting. Similarly, in Bharatanatyam, color or varnam forms a very important component of a margam. Varnam literally means colors. It is a joyous combination of all the three foundational aspects of Bharatanatyam, including pure footwork or nritha, expressive and emotive storytelling or nritya, and the combination of both or natya. A varnam is the longest and most elaborate item in a Bharatanatyam recital and is a test of the dancer's stamina, training and skill to successfully alternate between nritya and abhinaya. Today's varnam is in praise of Lord Venkateshwara, the presiding deity of Tirumala Hills. The varnam elaborates how the devotees swarm the seven hills back and forth like the waves of the ocean to have a glimpse of the beautiful face of the Lord. His greatness and grandeur cannot be explained in words. He is the one who brought clarity to the confused Arjuna in the Mahabharata battlefield through the divine Bhagavad Gita. To elaborate on the Lord's compassion to mankind and the devas, the story of Kuchela and Mahabali Chakravarti are elaborated in this varna. I now invite Sanjita to come on stage and demonstrate these two stories. Kuchela, a childhood friend of Krishna, was a poor Brahmin who was married with many children. He supported his family by begging for alms. Unable to tolerate the hardships, his wife suggests a visit to Lord Krishna in the hope that he will alleviate their problems. Although reluctant, Kuchela agrees. Unwilling to let her husband go empty-handed, his wife gives him a handful of aval or beaten rice as an offering. Kuchela sets out to meet his friend. On reaching the palace at Dwaraka, Krishna is delighted to see his childhood friend. He notices the small bag in Kuchela's hand and grabs it open and enjoys his favorite snack. Overwhelmed by the love shown by Krishna, Kuchela does not ask for help and takes leave of him. However, on his return, he is pleasantly surprised to see his small hut transformed into a huge mansion and his wife and children adorned with good clothes and jewelry. He then realizes the compassion and mercy of the Lord. The next story is that of Mahabali. Mahabali Chakravarti was an Asura king who wanted to perform a yajna. In preparation of the yajna, the king was honoring his people's wishes by giving away various material possessions. The devas were afraid of Mahabali's growing powers and sought the help of Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu took the avatar of a poor and dwarf Brahmin named Vamana and came to the kingdom of Mahabali. The disguised Lord Vishnu asks for land that could be measured by his three footsteps. Mahabali grants him his wish. His guru Shukracharya, realizing that Vamana is none other than Lord Vishnu, transforms himself into a bee and blocks the spout of the kamandala, which is used customarily to grant the wish. Lord Vishnu picks up a blade of grass and clears the spout, thereby blinding the Asura guru Shukracharya in one eye. To the astonishment of Mahabali, Vamana then grows immensely in size. With the first footstep, he covers the entire earth. With the second footstep, he covers the skies. And then he asks Mahabali where he should place his third footstep. Mahabali realizes this is none other than Lord Vishnu and asks him to place the third footstep on his own head. Vamana does so, pushing Mahabali into the netherworld. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to mention at this point that one of the highlights of Lavanya's guru Srimati Radha's choreography is the Mridanga Jadi. This marks the onset of the second half of the Varnam, which is usually at a faster tempo than the first. You will witness the beautiful synchronization of Mridangam on one hand and the footwork of the dancer on the other. It is a wonderful compilation of complex and fast beat patterns that the dancer has to perform with perfect precision, yet another challenging aspect of a Varnam. Devar Munivar, Varnam composed by violin maestro Lal Gudi Shri G. Jayaraman in Ragam Shanmugapriya, set to Adi Thala.
Nadan deva muniva
ta 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 de ta ta de teiya teiya ta kundari ki ta ka ta 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 de ta ta de teiya teiya ta kundari ki ta ka ta 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 tak tak gedde tak gedde tay tak gedde ta tak gedde tay tak gedde tak gedde tak gedde tak tak teyya 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 ta 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 de tak teyya 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 ta 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 de tak teyya 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 ta ta de tak teyya 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 ta ta de tak teyya teyya teiya ta 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 de satteiya teiya teiya ta 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 de tat tat gedita tat 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 gedita tat tat gedita 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 ganaka ganatta joluta jolutta dimita ta uding ke na utom tadding kinatom tadding kinatom tadding kinatom tadding kinatom tat tat gedita tat 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 gedita tat tat gedita 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 ganat ganat joluta jolutta dimita da uding ke na uto tadding kinatto tadding kinatto tadding kinatto tadding kinatto tat tat gedita tat 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 gedita tat tat gedita 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 ganat ganat joluta jolutta dimita da uding ke na Tom, that thing in that 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 tom.
Oh,
kajjundu kari kadini kari chakkar kari ka ganda kari ka jundu kari ka dimi kari ka kitta kari ka ranna kari ka jundu kari ka dimi kari ka kittari ka dhanari ka jonnuri ka dimi ka kadari 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 pakkari kitta kadata kadari 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 pakkari kitta kadata kadari
re ya 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 dir magal pure mar bal ma vali vali bai adaga dir mar ma vali vali bai kala adaga
Tak, 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 tak Thank you. Alangkaram
A challenging Varnam, and Sanjita's footwork and Abhinaya were outstanding.
Let's give it up one more time for Sangeeta and the amazing orchestra. Our chief guest for this evening needs no introduction. She is the founder and artistic director of Anjali Center of Performing Arts in Houston, Dr. Ratna Kumar. Dr. Ratna Kumar is an icon of Indian classical dance who's been called a jewel in the crown of Houston arts by the Houston media. In 1975, she established Texas' first Indian dance institute, the Anjali Center for Performing Arts, where more than 3,000 students from all over the US have received dance education in the past 45 years, and many have won local and national awards. Dr. Ratna Kumar has received training in Bharatanatyam, Kuchipudi, and Abhinaya from reputed gurus Kalaimamani K.J. Sarasa, Padma Bhushan awardee Dr. Vempati Chinnasatyam, Mailapur Gauri Ammal, and Kalanidhi Narayanan. She has been honored with a congressional recognition nomination to the Texas Women's Hall of Fame, 4 Lifetime Achievement Awards, and titles of Nritya Seva Mani, Vishwakala Bharati, and Madhura Kalamani. In 2011, she became the first Indian American to receive the Government of India's prestigious Sangeet Natak Academy Award for Excellence in Performing Arts in the Kuchipudi repertoire. She has 31 original dance productions to her credit and has received 13 individual artist fellowship grants for choreography from the City of Houston through the Houston Arts Alliance, the Texas Commission on the Arts, and the National Endowment for the Arts, and has also served as a panelist for all three. Dr. Ratna Kumar currently teaches Bharatanatyam at Rice University, is a teaching artist with the Young Audiences of Houston, a member of UNESCO's International Dance Council, Dance Source Houston, and Association of Bharatanatyam Artists of India. Without further ado, I would like to invite Dr. Ratna Kumar on stage, please.
Namaskaram. I'm here as a very special, not guest, but extended family member of Shiva's and Mahalakshmi's. My association with Shiva goes back to a couple of generations. I have known his great uncle, his grandfather, and his father. And in the capacity of an ammama, as Sangeeta calls me, I'm here as a very proud grandmother today. I have seen this child from the time she was a baby. She was one of the cutest babies. And she has blossomed into a beautiful young lady, a very loving, affectionate child. And today, I have seen the side of her that I've been waiting to see for a long time. Sangeeta, the dancer. Today she has come into her own with excellent training by her very loving and nurturing guru, Srimati Lavanya Prabhu. Being a Telugu like Shiva and Mahalakshmi, I want to say a phrase in the Telugu language. It says, Puvvu puttagane parimalam. A jasmine diffuses its fragrance the moment the bud emerges. It does not need to fully blossom for the world to know that this is a fragrant flower. Its perfume is felt. And it's the same with Sanchita. Not only that she carries those genes in her, coming from the illustrious Chinta family, one of the first families of Kuchipudi. By the way, when Kuchipudi, which was originally Kuchelapuram, was given as a gift to some two Bhagavata families by the Tanisha, the Muslim ruler of the land, the gift was given because he was completely mesmerized by their performance of the Yakshagana, Usha Paraniyam. And the first 15 families to have moved into Kuchelapuram, which later changed its name to Kuchipudi, one of them was Chinta. So Chinta family is one of the first families of Kuchipudi. And Sanchita carries that blood in her veins. And it is not at all surprising that she should take to dancing like a duck takes to water. But what I saw today was not a 12-year-old. I know her physical age, as do the rest of you. But it was more than that. I saw Sanchita was way more mature than her years. And her control. It's very difficult to see young children not losing their cool and maybe sometimes getting a little nervous or a little apprehensive sometimes, because this is, after all, a solo performance. It's a little nerve-wracking for a child. But there was no evidence of any of that, because Sanchita seemed like she was very comfortable on the stage. And, you know, she's just sailed through her dances with aplomb. And I think that is an extremely wonderful quality for a young girl, that the fact that she enjoys and revels in her dance, and that she's so involved that everything else fades away, as was seen especially in the Varnam, where it's my Kuladevam, so I was feeling very involved in the dance, and it was beautifully, beautifully portrayed by Sanchita. And maturity was also, I saw plenty of that also in her Abhinaya. You can, as they say, you can take a horse to the water, but you cannot make it drink it. Grace, layajnanam, Abhinaya, it's very difficult to teach, very difficult. You can try very hard, but those are native to a student. So in complete evidence was her extraordinary emoting skills, her very good command of talam, and her ease with which she did the footwork and the entire dance. It just it felt like she really didn't need to put much effort. She was just in it. As I said, she was reveling in her dance. And a big hand to the guru, because a child may have talent, but the gurus are the catalysts. They are the ones who bring that talent out. They give everything to every student of theirs. And there are students who blossom and spread their perfume, like Sanchita, and that is a reward that a teacher asks for. I'm sure Lavanya feels amply rewarded today by the wonderful performance of her Sishya. And you are an excellent teacher, Lavanya, as has been seen so far. God bless you with many years of spreading joy in the world, with teaching, with propagating this extraordinary, ancient, and everlasting beautiful dance form of Bharatanatyam. I commend all the artists on the stage who have contributed so beautifully to the completeness of today's performance. Shiva and Mahalakshmi, what can I say? I feel truly like a family member. Shiva said something very beautiful to me, very touching. He said, now that you're here, I'm not missing my mother as much. I felt her absence, but with you here, I'm happy. So as Shiva's other mom and Sanjita's mama. I take great pride and great joy in blessing this child. May her dance career go on and on for a long time, no matter what else she chooses as her path in life. May this always be a very integral part of her life, because some people are meant to dance. Thank you. Namaskar.
Thank you so much, Auntie, for those words of encouragement and motivation. It truly means a lot to us that you were able to grace us today. We also have several esteemed gurus from the Houston dance community in our audience today. We would now like to honor and thank them for being here and blessing Sanjita on her milestone recital. I now invite Srimati Padmini Chari, founder and artistic director of Nritya School of Dance. Srimati Indrani Patsardi, founder of Abhinaya School of Performing Arts. Srimati Darshi Ramachandra, founder of Darshi School of Dance. And Mr. Venugopal Joshula, the assistant director of Anjali School of Performing Arts. I think this deserves a picture for sure. I request the gurus to please come to the center of the stage and let's capture this memory. On behalf of Sanjita and her parents, I'd like to thank you all once again for your presence this evening. Can I ask Ratna Aunty to please join us as well? Thank you once again. Next, Sanjita will dance to a padam in praise of the cosmic Tandava dance of Lord Nataraja. The padam describes the blissful dance of Lord Shiva in Chidambaram. The references to the story of Agastya, Tillai, and the Sollukattu Swaras makes this dance energizing, interesting, and beautiful. It is a celebration of Shiva, the cosmic dancer who balances creation and destruction. Natanam Adinar in Ragam Vasanta, set to Kandajati Atatalam, a composition of Gopalakrishna Bharatiyar.
Yeah.
The next Kriti is one of the most popular compositions of Saint Annamacharya in Telugu, in which he highlights the universal truth of oneness and omnipresence of God in all creatures alike. The word Tandanana is a slang used in the local folklore to give a rhythmic punch to the folk music, while Ahi, Pure and Bhalla are words of appreciation in the local language. Annamaya goes on to say that there is only one Parabrahman, the Supreme Lord, who is omnipresent. Nothing is despicable in this universe, since Lord Shri Hari dwells in each and every being, whether humans, animals, birds or insects. Whether it is the majestic king or a poor servant, or both, slumber is the same. Whether it is the learned Brahmin or the illiterate person, for both, Mother Earth is the same. Whether it be the mighty elephant or the little dog, for both, sunlight is the same. So also, the name of Lord Sri Venkateshwara is the same for all, be it a sinner or the holy one. He is the savior of the universe. Tandanana, in Ragam Bauli, said to Adi Talam, composed by the great devotee of Lord Venkateshwara, Sri Annamacharya. Thank you. That was a riveting piece of music, and Sanjita's rich facial expressions brought so much life to this beautiful padam. Let's hear it for her once again. We would now like to introduce the members of today's orchestra, who have added so much color and vibrancy to the evening's dance arangetram. Vocal by Srimati Deepika R. Charan, who won our hearts with her soulful and expressive rendition. Deepika is a disciple of Sangeeta Kala Acharya, Padma Shri Professor S.R. Janakiraman. She has been under the tutelage of this legendary musician and musicologist since 2012. She is learning rhythmic intricacies and laya aspects from renowned Mridangam Vidwan, Sri Erode Nagaraj. Earlier, Deepika had her training in vocal music from Srimati Lalita Shivakumar. Deepika has received numerous awards for excellence in vocal music and academics since school days. She is also a recipient of the reputed Balashri title from the former President of India, APJ Abdul Kalam. She is an aerospace engineer by qualification and works as a product analyst in the construction software industry. I now request Deepika to please come on stage. Providing rhythm for this evening on the mridangam, we have Sri Charan Rajan. Charan has had a passion towards the divine art of mridangam from childhood and has been undergoing intensive training from Sangeeta Kalanidhi Padma Vibhushan Umayalpuram Sri K. Shivaraman since 1999. Charan's training includes both accompaniment to vocal and instrumental music. He has accompanied many Bharatanatyam and Kuchipudi dance recitals in the United States. He has performed in many celebrated sabhas like Sri Krishnagana Sabha, Bharat Kalachar, and other well-known sabhas in and around Chennai city during the December music season. Charan has a master's from Carnegie Mellon University and an MBA from Rice. He currently resides in Cyprus and works as a senior process engineer. He also teaches the divine art of mridangam to students local and abroad. We would now like to have Charan on stage, please. Providing lovely accompaniment on the violin, we have Sri Shashidhar. Shashidhar began his music studies with Padma Shri Lalgudi Jayaraman at the age of 10 and received 12 years of intensive training. Under the Gurukula-like system of training, he absorbed the style of the Lalgudi school, of which he proves to be a worthy pupil. His concert debut was made in Sri Krishnagana Sabha in Chennai. From then on, he has played many solo concerts in India, USA, and Canada, accompanied leading artists such as T.N. Seshagopalan, Balamurli Krishna, N. Ramani, Ravi Kiran, and others. As an artist of All India Radio, he has played many recitals and has released a CD album, Indian Classical Music, The Other Facet. We request Shashidhar to please come on stage. We have another special member in the orchestra who's assisting with the Nattavangam today, Srimati Anita Menon. Srimati Anita Menon is a student of Padma Shri Srimati Chitra Vishweshwaran in Chennai. She is the founder and artistic director of the Anjali School of Dance in Portland, Oregon. Anita and her husband have recently moved here to Houston. She has co-directed and choreographed Chitra, the Girl Prince, Tenali, the Royal Trickster, as well as the Jungle Book at Northwest Children's Theatre. She went on to receive a Drammy Award for Best Choreographer for the 2019-2020 season. Anita was the first Asian American to receive the prestigious Artist Fellowship Award from the Regional Arts and Culture Council in Portland, Oregon. Anita Menon. And last but not the least, I would like to introduce our guru, Srimati Lavanya Prabhu. Lavanya Prabhu is an outstanding exponent of the Varavur style of Bharatanatyam. She is a senior disciple of Kalaimamani Guru Srimati Radha, one of the foremost teachers and choreographers of Bharatanatyam today, and a torchbearer of the Varavur Bani. Lavanya has performed extensively in India and abroad. Having trained in the Varavur Bani for over 3 decades, she considers it her responsibility to pass on this beautiful tradition to future generations. With over 20 years of experience as a teacher, Lavanya, upon her return to Houston in 2014, established the Tatvam School of Dance, where she meticulously trains the next generation of young talents with an emphasis on maintaining the purity and uniqueness of Varavur Bani. With its recent production Panchamam, Tatvam has made its mark as one of the premier Bharatanatyam schools in the greater Houston area. The production was a huge success and a testament to the quality and authenticity of the training the students receive at the school. Following Lavanya's footsteps, Tatvam's students have won multiple competitions in the USA, adding to the school's growing list of accomplishments. Academically, Lavanya holds a master's degree in computer science engineering. Her passion for Bharatanatyam led her to choose a career in the field of arts. Lavanya Prabhu. Request Lavanya to say a few words now.
Namaskaram, Shri Guru Bhyo Namaha. Thank you all so much for being here to support Sanjita on her very special day. Special thanks to our chief guest, Dr. Ratna Kumar. Thank you, Ratna Aunty, for your kind words of encouragement and for your blessings. And I would also like to thank all the esteemed gurus in the audience, Srimati Padmini Chari, Srimati Indrani Partha Sarathi, Srimati Darshi Ramachandra, and we also have another esteemed guru in the orchestra, Srimati Anita Menon. I'm sorry, we forgot to get your picture. Today is a very special day for many reasons. But before that, I think first I need to talk about our orchestra, a wonderful team of orchestra members. Thank you so much. It was wonderful, wonderful working with all of you. And I look forward to many more. And I fractured my right arm 3 weeks ago, right in the middle of my arangetrams. And it's been 3 weeks now. So my right hand is a little bit more functional today than it was for two of my arangetrams on the 18th and the 24th. And Anita here was my guardian angel. I called her and she said, she very graciously agreed to assist with the Natvangam. And Anita, you have my gratitude and I can never forget what you've done for me. Thank you so much. You know, it's not just that she was, you know, she offered to help. She's also somebody whom I felt very comfortable with. She made sure that she was not, you know, stepping over the line. Not that it would mean anything. I'm just saying, you know, she was so careful not to do that. Very accommodative. And it's just been a pleasure. And blessings come in many ways. And this was one of my blessings. Thank you, Anita. Thank you so much. And I truly mean every word that I said just now. Thank you. Now, coming to Sanjita. Sanjita was one of my very, very first students. I started teaching in 2014 with four children, all of them around 4, 5, or 6 years old, and Sanjita was one of them. I still remember her, you know, she was just round. I think I can say that. I can say that now. She was just round, and I remember her chubby cheeks, and they were hanging out of her face, and that's what I remember about her. And she's been an absolute pleasure to teach. I've taught her for 7 years now. And she has missed maybe about 3 or 4 classes in all of these 7 years. And what's even more amazing is her mom has missed only maybe 1 or 2 classes of all the classes that Sanjita attended. And that is a big reason why we have her dancing here today. And it is a crime if I don't mention that. I think Mahalakshmi is as capable of doing an arangetram as Sanjita is, and that is the truth. I think she knows the choreography just as much. She just needs a little bit of practice, that's all. And, you know, in the last 7 years, there are so many, I know, I'm just trying to collect my thoughts. I just don't want to keep blabbering. But when we decided that she is ready to do her arangetram, I told her, and soon after the pandemic struck, so we moved to virtual lessons. But I was not too concerned because I think I trusted that the child would do it and the mother was anyway there in all the classes. So that gave me the confidence that even with Zoom lessons, this will kind of work. But I did not expect so much. You know, when I started in-person lessons in April, yes, she had, you know, there were many corrections, but they were just finer corrections. They were not things like she was forgetting or anything. She had memorized the whole thing. And I remember Mahalakshmi sitting with a book and writing down everything in the, you know, in the class. She would sit and she would write down what all I said, and if Sanjita was finding it difficult to remember a particular core wise, she would actually write it down. And I think it is that encouragement and support from the parents that has made this possible today. Sanjita is a very, very talented child, no doubt, but without the support of parents, it's very difficult, you know, especially in this country, especially with the pandemic. It would have not been possible had it not been for her parents. And, you know, I know you all know that she comes from a family of renowned dancers and teachers. But having said that, that may give her a little bit of an advantage over other children who do not have a similar background. But I think we should not undermine the hard work and effort put in by this child to get where she is today. She has worked so hard, and I'm not somebody to mince my words when it comes to criticism. I mean, even if you, I've always said it because I wanted her to do better, but you know, children at this age, they tend to get very touchy. They can take it, you know, may not take it in the right attitude, but she took it in the right spirit and she's worked very, very hard. And I personally feel hard work, dedication, sincerity, and persistence are 4 qualities that are very important Of course, you need the divine blessings, but you need these four qualities to do anything successfully. And Sanjita has all of these qualities. And I'm incredibly proud of Sanjita. And I would now like to invite Sanjita to come on the stage to get her Arangetram certificate. You know, there is a saying, Yellu Bdingarthukulla Yennaya Nikkirana. I think that is Sanjita for you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we now come to the concluding item of this evening's recital. Tillana is a rhythmic composition presented as a finale number in a Bharatanatyam margam. Tillanas are fast in tempo with intricate rhythmic sequences. The movements of a tillana are joyous and expansive, giving it a vivacious quality. In this culminating piece, the dancer performs a series of graceful body movements set to complex and intricate rhythms, highlighting the dancer's proficiency in timing, synchronization, and extreme physical strength and stamina. This tilana is in praise of Lord Muruga. The poet says, O Lord Muruga, who's seated majestically on a peacock with fanned out tail and dotted feathers, shower your divine grace on me and liberate me from the darkness of my karma. Tillana, in Ragam Tilang, set to Aditalam, a composition of Lalgudi Shri G. Jayaraman.
Then maybe. मग किट तज्जम मणिपन्नी
Love the energy. That was a fantastic finale, Sanjita. I now request Maha and Shiva to come to the stage and give the vote of thanks.
I hope everyone has enjoyed the program today. It's truly a privilege and pleasure to have you all here to watch Nidha Savangetram. Maha and I thank you all for your blessing, support, and also choosing to spend your evening on this Sunday with us here. That means a really lot to our family, and it means a lot to us. This has been an experience for our lifetime. We are very proud of Sanjita for the amount of work she has put in to achieve this milestone in just absolutely mind-blowing. This wouldn't have been happened possible without her guru, Lavanya. Sanjita's performance today is a reflection of Lavanya's hard work, commitment, and patience. Lavanya, your determination and perfection to minute details has shown your dedication to the Varur Bani. Sanjita is blessed to have your guidance and support. Thank you so much for making this wonderful journey for Sanjita and for us. Thank you. We are very fortunate to have our wonderful orchestra amongst us. It is such a magical and mesmerizing moment. And listen, thank you so much. Our heartfelt thanks to our chief guest, Dr. Ratna Aunty, and for your graceful presence and kind words and blessing. Our thanks to all the dance teachers for taking time off to attend Sanjita's performance today. Thank you all. Thank you so much. And thanks to Sridevi Joshila, who is our vocal teacher, who is also in the audience. Thank you so much. I also want to thank a special family who is in the audience today, who is Anant's uncle and auntie, who have been a great support and blessing us ever since we've known them. Thank you so much, Anant's uncle and auntie. Thanks to the wonderful clicks from Murali Santana and also our dear friend Thiru, who is sitting right in front of me. I know even diamond needs to be cut and polished to make it shine. I know my daughter is beautiful and looked good at, but you know, you need a golden pair of hands to make them look brighter.
Thanks.
To Beth Harden, who is here, you've done an amazing job. I should thank MTS team and staff and support team who has done a wonderful job for the audio, video, and lighting and making this possible this evening today. Thank you so much, the MTS team. I have to thank the wonderful decor that is you see on the stage, in the podium, and in the dais. Padma from Elegant Decors. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. And last but not least, I should thank Smita, who is our MC for this evening, to shepherding us all along for the last 3 hours, which has been a great job. Now, this is the most toughest part to say thanks. I should thank all my dear friends who have helped us throughout this journey for the past year. Small, big, whatever, any time of the day, people, friends, were very happily willing to help us out. I couldn't take names anymore here on the stage, but I thank each one of you all who are sitting here and who are sitting abroad for all the great support and help throughout this journey. Thank you all.
Thank you, Shiva and Maha. This surely is a proud moment for you both. I'd now like to invite the final and most special speaker of this evening, our celebrated performer, Ms. Sanjita Chinta.
you all for coming and supporting me on my very special day. I would like to thank a couple people before I'd like to thank my parents. Thank you for my Berima, who's sitting abroad and watching me and supporting me, whether she's over a screen, but she's always here in spirit. Next, I'd like to thank Anantam, Tata, and Padma Mama for supporting me through the audience. Next, I'd like to thank Ratna Aunty, or Ratna Mama, as she calls me, for coming and supporting me through the audience and always been a part of my dance journey. Now, I'd also like to thank Tara Mama for also supporting me throughout my dance journey. Next, I'd like to thank my mom for making all the arrangements and connecting the dots to make this day read as smoothly as possible. I also like to thank her for her sincere determination by writing the jatis and saying them with me so I understand them, and being a second to Lavanyanti, correcting me in my mistakes. Next, I'd like to thank my dad for all the comedic support he's provided me, and every time I get frustrated or I need a little push, he always would make the most weirdest but funny jokes to make me go that extra mile. Next, I'd like to thank the orchestra for patiently cooperating with me so I could get a feel for performing with a live orchestra and repeating as many as times as I need them to. Now I'd like to say thanks to my mama and my atta for coming from Kansas City and motivating me and giving me a third person point of view on all of my performances. Last but not least, I would like to thank Lavanyanti. Thank you, Aunty, for being patient with me and making sure I knew every item, like the back of my hand and every jati and all the finer corrections by heart. You always pushed me to my full potential and have never doubted me. And every time you'd send me to compete, you'd never have a doubt in me and you'd send me with full confidence. And I hope you made me proud today. Thank you.
Thank you, Sanjita, and I can say for sure that you've made many people proud today. The program now concludes with a mangalam, where Sanjita will pay her respects to God, her guru, the orchestra, and the audience.